بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبده ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، then brothers, I want to mention three things. The first one is something that I mentioned when we were doing the Umrah training, the seminar, which was that I mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings you to this house as a guidance. Allah made this house, this place, this Kaaba, a place of guidance. You know, فيه هدى. In it there is guidance. And he mentioned in Surah Al Imran and in Surah Al Ma'idah that this place is a reason for you to be guided. That when you come here, you see that your heart gets closer to Allah. You see that you become more worship. Everyone's seen this. We all felt this. We felt that our hearts were closer to Allah. Our iman was higher. We wanted to pray. We wanted to do dhikr. Like one of the brothers earlier, he said that when I do dhikr, I get energy and I want to do more. And I want to stay awake until 12 a.m. at night, you know, just to pray and to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose you guys, every single one of you, to come to this house. That's the first thing. The second thing is for you to remember that Allah azza wa jal, is for you to remember that feeling that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you, that He guided you to this iman, and He left thousands, rather billions of people without this guidance. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose every single one of you. There was not one of you who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you came here by accident. No one here can say they deserve to come here. Why was I chosen and this other the person who's going on the streets in London or back home and he's doing haram, and rather he doesn't even believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he's getting doubts. Why was you chosen and you not, and that person was not chosen? It's because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose you out of his mercy. This is from the mercy of Allah azza wa jal. So for that reason, I want to mention the third point, and that is what Allah says in the Quran, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ أَنْكَاثَ. Don't be like the woman. There was a woman in Mecca. See, she used to sit down and she used to knit. You know, when you knit clothing. She used to knit clothing. And when she finished knitting it and it would look nice, it's finished, it's done, what would she do? She would tear it apart bit by bit, one by one. One by one. Allah says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ. Don't be like the one, that woman, who untied her all that work that she done, she untied it after it was strong. Brothers, don't be like that. Don't go back home after you came here and you saw the iman, you felt the iman, you felt this thing that's going to get you closer to Jannah. You felt that sweetness. That Ibn Taymiyyah and other scholars, they said that there is a Jannah in this world, there's paradise in this world. If you don't feel it and if you don't enter it into it, you will not enter into the Jannah of the Akhirah. And what is that Jannah? It's that feeling that every single one of you felt. When one of you were doing Umrah, or after you've done Umrah, and you felt that peace. That's the Jannah that we're talking about. When one of you was going to the Kaaba, and you put your hands on the Kaaba, and you put your chest on the Kaaba, and you went to the black stone and you kissed it. That's the feeling that you got. That feeling is that Jannah that the scholars talked about, they spoke about. This Jannah is that you already entered into it, you felt it. Don't be like that woman who goes back now. Don't be like that woman who unties everything that you felt. Going back to Jahiliyyah, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the sinners. He says those people, they commit sins whilst they're ignorant. Meaning, every single person who commits a sin, he's ignorant at his time of sin. Don't be like that. That woman, you think she's crazy, right? She just spent all of that work. Every single one of you spent money, you spent your time off work. Energy. It wasn't easy to kiss the black stone of some of the brothers they'd done. They came back, you know, the thobes smelling. They came back, the thobes. It wasn't easy to do all of that stuff. It wasn't easy to wake up 3 a.m. every night. Don't go back to what you were doing before. Don't go, like Sheikh Asim, he mentioned, that the sign that your Umrah was accepted is that you go back a better person. Don't go back the person that you were before, ever. Because know that the people back home, they're waiting for you. They're waiting for a change. They either sent you here, or you were sent here, or you came here voluntarily, and your parents they were proud of you. They were saying, my son is going to come back a better person now. He's going to come back a better person. Don't be ungrateful to your parents. Don't be ungrateful to Allah, who gave you this opportunity. And ishkur li wali walidayk. Thank me, and thank your parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, thank me, and thank your parents. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gave you this opportunity. And thanking Allah is not just by words, saying Alhamdulillah, I was given this opportunity. It's by change. Your actions that you do is going to show if you're really thankful. Allah says in the Quran, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ. Remember when your Lord, He announced, He made an announcement. This is a constitution, a rule that's going to happen. لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ. If you thank me, لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. I'm going to increase you. وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ. And if you are ungrateful, إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. They know that my punishment is harsh. Know that, brothers and brothers, this gift that Allah gave to you, you are either going to meet it with thankfulness, or being unthankful. Meaning you're not going to have gratitude to Allah. The thankfulness to Allah is to go back and change yourself, and being ungrateful is to go back and do what you want, and after Allah showed you the guidance, you throw yourself into the hellfire. Brothers, don't remember that. This opportunity, Allah took you to a place of guidance. This is the place of guidance mentioned in the Quran. Don't ever forget that. I said three things, but one more thing. And that is how we're going to do this. Brothers, there's two things. Number one, keep this brotherhood. See this brotherhood that we had? The brothers went yesterday, how we felt. The brothers all together, generally, how we felt. When we're sitting down right now, this brotherhood, keep it. Have good friends. Don't go back to those bad friends who influence you on the streets, who influence you to do bad things. Don't go back to those friends. And number two, learn knowledge. Learn knowledge, brothers. Learn the knowledge of Islam. Learn this knowledge, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man yurid Allahu bihi khayran yufaqihu fi al-din." Whoever Allah wants good for, He makes him learn the religion, gives him fiqh, understanding in this religion. If you want to be someone who Allah wants good for, go and tread that path of knowledge. Try to seek even a little bit. Tread that path of knowledge, because that's what's going to keep you firm. The good brothers and the knowledge that's going to keep your iman on the rise. Don't just be a person who's just going to be going to, you know, energy drinks boosts. You know, it's like a boost. You go to a conference. Not like that. Iman, it has a foundation, and that foundation is knowledge. Okay? So that's what I wanted to say. And inshallah, I'll pass it on to the brothers. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen.
Assalamu alaikum. I want to take you to the Day of Judgment. I want you to imagine yourself opening your book of deeds and getting disappointed as you scroll over the pages, realizing that there's not a lot here. In fact, as you turn over the pages, you see there's quite a bit of sin. And the good deeds don't really match up to what they should have. But suddenly as you turn over the pages, you start to see all of these good deeds, like memorizing Quran, seeking knowledge, praying the night prayer. But you're thinking to yourself, hold up, I never memorized the Quran. I didn't used to do all of these extra deeds, like pray the night prayer on a consistent basis. How is it in my book of deeds when I never personally did it? And then it becomes clear to you that this is in your book of deeds because there was a person who you helped to guide towards al-Islam. And when they came to Islam and changed their life, you now received all of the good that they did, even though you didn't personally do it yourself. As you know, الدال إلى الخير كفاعله. The one who guides someone to do good will have the reward of that good the way the person who did it, even if you yourself didn't do it. And this is why it's so important, brothers and sisters, for us to support people when it comes to helping change their life. Now, as you know, this is the work that me and my team are involved in. With the permission of Allah Azza wa Jal, we've been changing people's lives for the last few years. And we've got many projects from Mantingan Masjid to Knowledge College. But the one project that we've seen that's changed people's life above and beyond anything else that we've seen, with Allah's permission, is our Umrah trips. We take people who are literally off the streets, involved in drugs, violence, just come out of prison, soon maybe possibly going to prison, all different backgrounds. We take them on these Umrah trips, and there Allah Azza wa Jal transforms their hearts, puts light inside of them, and they come back reformed men. An example of one such brother who we took, he actually came back, and within one space of a year, he took 70 people from his area, from the streets into the masjid. Some of them came onto Deen hard, some of them not as much as others, but he impacted his local community. And he himself has now gone on to seek knowledge, memorize Quran, learn the Arabic language, and he's actively involved in khair. Now, this brother wasn't able to fund his whole package. He was funded for by someone generous, someone like you. And they probably had no idea that they were going to pay for this brother's ticket, that he was going to be impacted so much on trip that when he came back, he was going to help get 70 people from his area into the masjid from streets. And imagine that person who gave money for that trip. What reward they're gonna see on the Day of Judgment. And that's one. We've taken over 150 people in just over a year. And now this November, we're taking our biggest group yet, 60 plus people. And these are the brothers who are in most need. 17 of them were taken absolutely free, because they can't afford the trip themselves. Either they don't have the money or their money is haram. But they want to change. Do you want the reward for them changing? If so, then go to the link below, because we have to fundraise for 10 of them in the next 7 days. Someone's definitely going to give that money, inshallah, and take that reward. Is it going to be you? That's the question. And inshallah, you'll see that reward in the Day of Judgment. So I advise you, for the sake of Allah, go to the link below, say Bismillah, donate whatever you can. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.